Hello and welcome back. Last time we learned how to create a user form with a combo box and two labels and populate the combo box with data from the worksheet. Let me just revise that for you. So I'm going to click on the run button, and there you see we had this user form here, we had the data from the worksheet, and this data appeared here in the combo box automatically. It gave us a label with the information that these are the number of hard disks available. These are two labels here. Okay. Now the data that we got here using collections was unique. That means no data was repeated. For example, hard disk drive is here in this worksheet twice, but you see it only once. Now, many people emailed me and said, can we sort the data here in the list so that it's easier for us to select? So that is what we are going to do today. So I'm going to exit this. We will double click on this workbook. And here, instead of general, the object, we will take workbook and open is our procedure. Between these two lines of code now, we will write our code to sort this data. So our data starts at A1 right up to C9. Okay. So I'll go back to the developer. And now I will select the range. Okay. So range. And thinking about the future, I will select the complete columns. Okay, I will not select A2 to C10, but I will select A to C. That means I select the columns completely. Okay, dot select. Once that is selected, I need to define a key range on which I wish to sort. For example, I wish to sort my data based on the items. Okay, and if the items are sorted, I want, of course, my quantity purchased and quantity sold to be related to that. That means this data should not change if the sorting here changes. All right, so we will say active workbook, and this is a good thing to do to give the complete path. Active workbook dot worksheets. We are in sheet 1, so we will say sheet 1. Please remember, if you have a sheet called data or expenses or income, then please use that sheet name. Don't use sheet 1. Okay. The rest of the code will remain the same. So we will say dot sort. Dot sort fields, and our key will be the range A, the complete range A, because I'm thinking that in future you will add more data to this range, therefore we should not select A2 to A10, but the whole column. Okay, so comma, and we will sort on. So sort on XL. We will sort on values. Okay, and what will be the sort order? We want the order to be ascending. You can of course write descending if you wish to have it descending. And that is written like this. This is the grammar. And then our data option of the sorting is normal. Data option. We This data option Excel sort normal just ensures that the text and numerical values are sorted properly. Sometimes a user can make a mistake. Instead of entering an item name, he might just enter a number. Okay, it can happen. So we take care of that also. Now, this VBA code will be available on the website. Okay, so we will next say with active workbook. Dot worksheets. We again select our sheet 1. Dot sort. And now with the active, so I forgot something. Let me just see what I forgot. With active workbook dot worksheets. Oops, I forgot a quote here. Okay, that's done. Little mistakes and Excel starts shouting, so be careful. Now, once we have given this with command here, we can use the dot values, dot set, range. You then don't need to write other things once you write with. So dot set range. Range, our range that we want to sort is A to C. We are not specifying A2 to C10, but we want the complete columns to be selected. Then dot header. Do our columns have a header? Yes, they have. So we will say Excel yes. Now, how do we want the orientation? We want the our data is oriented from top to bottom. Okay, but you can leave this out if you wish. It's a good idea to add it. So top to bottom, because your data can also be horizontal, isn't it? Then we apply that dot apply. And because we started with, so we do an end with. And if our columns are not fitted properly, that means if the data is not inside the cells visible totally, then we can do something like this. You know that from earlier videos, columns A to C dot entire column. Dot out of it. This will fit our data into the column so that we can see them easily. Okay. Now we can finish, but to get our cursor somewhere so that we can see it, we can just say range A1, let's say dot select. This is of course going to select the header items. Okay. So if everything in this code is perfect, then our data will be sorted in the worksheet. Okay, so I'll minimize this first. Okay, so we'll close this now, file close, because we have said this action happens only on open. So we will close this first. Of course, Excel will ask you whether you would like to save it. So you say save, and we go to file, and we go back to our workbook. So click on it, and it says named argument not found. So we can debug this. The reason is either your data should be a name range, or you should write here sort fields dot add, which I forgot, because once you add the key, then everything will be fine. And this keyword was important. Okay, so I'm going to run this now, and there you see the data has been saved. Do you notice that? Now if I go back to Visual Basic, Go to the user form, double click on it, open it and run this user form. Of course you see this hard disk drive because I have told Excel to show the list index 0. I'll just show you that code. So if you click on this now, do you notice that this is all sorted in ascending order? Okay, now we'll exit this and let me show you that code. And you see here combo box list index 0. It should show the first item. Okay, now I'm going to minimize this and add something. Let's say I add cabinets. Okay, and I purchased 12 on some date. Then I add RAM, let's say. Oops. And I sold, let's say, 6. And I take cabinets again. And this time I sell 10 cabinets. And now I'll just save this. File close. Open the file. So when I open the file, you notice here data has been sorted. Go to Visual Basic, run this form again, user form, and you see here the data has been sorted. And there are no duplicate entries here as I showed you last time. And it also gives out a message that total cabinets available is 10 because we bought 12 and sold 10. I hope you found this interesting and useful. Thanks for watching.